I am come to send fire on the earth. In Wales, we have the tradition of powerful preaching, often referred to precisely as fiery preaching. Power in the word. Sermons, and indeed retreats, can sway souls forever. There was something of that I found actually when I was 17 in France. The sermon seemed a whole art there, cultivated. The sermons were longer and they were well structured. And one sermon, one Saturday evening, changed my life. It was the sermon at Rouen in the church of St. Joan of Arc. But the priest had been on retreat to La Trappe and spoke well about the interior life. La Trappe, specifically. It was a seed. But over the years, one sees there are places here and there where it is not always taken seriously. One obstacle, actually, is when the preacher is not actually preaching in the Welsh sense as we would have it, with that fire, but reading a text, hardly looking at his people. The fire there is absent. It has to be alive. There has to be passage of soul, passage of heart and feeling, in such a way that not only words are communicated, but energy. A saint who did this well is the saint of this day, St. Anthony Mary Claret. He had a huge influence in his time, a troubled time, the 1800s in Spain and Cuba. He had influence through his link with the royal family, to which he was faithful and followed them into exile, where he died at the Cistercian Abbey of Fontfroid on this day in 1870. He wrote many works, actually well over 100 books, and he was a herald of the teaching which comes through in the documents of the Second Vatican Council, indicating that all are called to the radicality of the gospel according to their state. It would be well to remember that, for one can at times, if one isn't careful, get into a situation where, in the interests of maintaining something which was founded well and in a certain way, one can forget the actual underlying gospel value of charity. We are not here to uphold a system, but to love and to love others into being, precisely with warmth, yes, and fire. For there is one evangelizer which works across the board and can enkindle something even in a soul which is far removed from faith. For the one common element that we have on earth is our humanity, and this is the bridge between our soul and theirs, and potentially between the heart of the Saviour and theirs. For if we evangelise with our whole being, and if our whole being is an icon of that love, then the Lord is free to act. If we let other things get in the way, we are a nuisance. Lord, use me. Make me burn. Make me a lamp, burning with heat and fire for you, and with heat and fire for the souls that you made.
Ooh.